When I am, happiness is a very simple emotion. The only needed is happiness. And happiness can be anything. It can be painting for hours. It can be going to a party. It can be studying for hours for some people. It can be running. It can be dancing. It can be anything. Find out what happiness is for you. Figure out what it is for you and go after it. Chase after it with everything that you've got. There is this one quote from the movie Pursuit of Happiness. Don't ever let someone tell you you can't do something. If you have a dream, you have to protect it. When people tell you you can't do something, it's because they can't do it themselves. But if you want something, you have to go and chase after it. Ask yourself if you're happy, and if you hesitated on the answer, you need to go out there and figure out what it is that is making you happy. To me, happiness is playing. Happiness is competing. Happiness is the journey that takes me to the podium, that makes me feel the weight of the medal around my neck. That's what happiness is. Happiness is the little things. Waking up early in the morning might not sound like something that would make you happy now, but when you reach your goal, when you look back, that's what happiness was for you. Don't be that person who looks back halfway through your life and feels that they haven't done what they wanted to. Don't look back at life and regret that you haven't gotten what you wanted. I started tennis at the age of 7. And I used to tag along with my brother, who used to go to the academy, and it sparked an interest in me. Or at least that's what I really tell people. The real reason I started playing tennis was in the US Open 2016. Maria Sharapova was wearing this beautiful black dress with like the shiny stones and everything. And I looked at that dress and said, that is what I want to do. That is what I want to be. I didn't know who she was. I didn't know what she achieved. All I cared was that fancy dress. That's what I wanted to wear. And I feel like it's okay to want things for strange reasons. It's okay to want things for the fame or for the money. I mean, I enjoyed the press I got when I was a kid. I was 8 years old and my picture came in the paper, and that's when I knew that that's what I wanted to do. It's okay to not have to be passionate, and dreams are not always the cliched things. It can be anything. But that was happiness for me, the shiny clothes and the fabulous press. And as I grew older, around the age of 14, I decided that I want to take it up professionally. And I went up to my parents and said, hey, mom and dad, I want to change schools. And like any regular parents, they reacted like, why? And then I sat them down and I convinced them and I said, I want to become a professional tennis player, and for that I'll have to travel and I'll have to compete in tournaments week in, week out. And they listened to me. They said, you know what, okay, I'm going to give you the opportunity. Let's see what you can do. So then I switched schools, but I wasn't working hard. The minute I switched schools, I just started slacking off. I wasn't actually traveling for the tournaments that I wanted to. And then something snapped inside of me, and then I realized, what am I doing? What is the point of me switching schools if I wasn't going to pursue what I wanted? So then again, I went to my parents, sat them down, and I said, I have to start traveling, I'm working, and I need to start traveling if I need to play the tournaments that I want to participate in. And we figured it out. My mom gave up everything so she could travel with me. And for the first 6 months, it was really good, and I was climbing up the ranks, and it was the dream. I was getting to it. But then I hurt my knee. I hurt my knee really badly, and I was told that for 6 months I couldn't live. And for the first 2 weeks, I wasn't even allowed to walk. And at the age of 14 or 15, hearing something like that is very difficult to handle. I mean, you feel like, what is the point of putting all this effort if I'm going through so much pain? And it was a tough time for me. And my coach, Nagraj sir, he got me through this. He really realized that I needed somebody to back me, even though I was going through a tough time. And I worked, and I got back. And in the first 2 months that I got back, I injured my back again. In the span of 1 year, I had 2 major injuries at the age of 15. And that's something that's very hard to fight. The second time was way harder because, I mean, I was giving up hope by then. What is the point, right? But my family and my brother and my coach, they really got me through it. And I came back stronger, more determined. And having sat down this entire time, watching all my friends do so much better, I felt like I had to catch up a lot. But what really gave me perspective was that I realized how much I really loved playing. Before that, I just thought I was just having fun. But then I realized that I really loved the sport for what it was. And I got back and I won the Mumbai Nationals. I had to play through the pain. And I won the Mumbai Nationals in under 16. And that's when it began for me. A sport like tennis teaches you a lot because every week you have to keep traveling. And unless you win a tournament, you're coming back home a loser. So even if you lose in the first round or in the quarterfinals, you're coming back home a loser. And tennis teaches me that how to accept a loss, you know? Because 1 week I might win the tournament, I might be able to cherish the victory. But the next week if I lose, I have to accept it. And as a kid, I really hated losing. I mean, don't we all hate losing? But it was like, I would throw a tantrum every time I lost a match. Once when I lost a match, I slammed the door, wrote a note, kept it outside my room saying, don't come in, I lost, I don't want anybody to talk to me. So everyone in my family used to just lose to me at those small tiny games that we play, just to satisfy me. But my mom, she wouldn't let that happen. She did not like that I was getting away with things. And no matter what I was playing, it might be caroms or chess or a pack of cards, she would make me earn my victory. She would never let me win just like that. And that's one of the biggest lessons that I've learned, that you need to be able to earn your victories and accept your losses. Because at the end of the day, in a sport like this, you lose a lot more than you win. Tennis also has taught me how to balance my education with my tennis, because what somebody studies in 4 hours in school, I had to do in an hour and a half because of the lack of time that I had. And it really helps you with your work ethic and the discipline that you have. And I wasn't the most hardworking kid, let me be honest. I had a lot of talent, so I got away with a lot of stuff. But talent can only get you to some level, okay? Because I didn't do the hard work and just did the talent part, that's why I started getting injured. So I got it together. I can say with all my heart that in the last 2 or 3 years, I really have put in the hard work that I didn't as a kid. And that really has changed me as a person. But my brother always said that you should always leave a legacy, make a mark, change lives, make a difference. And I'm never going to accept that I'm saying this, but he has made a difference in my life. When I finished my 10th grade and I wanted to pursue tennis, my family, being the typical family, wanted me to take sciences in my 11th and 12th. And he saved me. He stepped up and said, look, you know what, if she wants to do the tennis and she wants to do the arts, let her. Because he didn't have the privilege to pursue what he wanted at that age. And he saved me. So then I took up arts and kept going. And going through my dreams. But one of the most amazing things that happened to me was last year in December when I got the call saying, you've been selected to play the South Asian Games. And I was thrilled. And it wasn't something that we all have that dream of playing for the country far ahead in our lives, but I've been blessed by this opportunity. And I didn't really realize the heaviness of the situation until I was standing on the podium with the medal and the national anthem was playing. That's when I knew that I got to where I was. And in that tournament, my roommate was this person called Prarthana Tomre, who's an Olympian. And she said something very interesting that is going to be my new quest. So this pin that they give us like a bunch of pins when you go to South Asian Games or an Asian Games. And what you do is you take this pin and you give it to somebody from another country. And they give you their pin, their country's pin. So I found this concept really fun because I collected all the 7 pins of that tournament. And Prarthana Tomre told me, I collected about 80 pins when I went to the Olympics. And that's it. I knew what my next quest is. It's the pins. I got my dress. Now it's my pins. So when I came back from the tournament and one of my friends said, wow, you're so lucky, you're getting to do this, you're getting to travel. And as a kid, I used to get very, very offended by that. Because I used to feel like my hard work was being undermined. Like, this isn't luck, I'm working for it, right? But now that I've grown up, I realized I really am lucky. Because not enough people in this world, not enough people in this country get to do what they want. They are not privileged enough to be allowed to have the freedom to chase after what they really want. And I would say, kids, you have to try. You have to try your best to pursue what you want. And parents, it might not be my place to say this, but back your child. Support them. Believe in them the way mine did, because the raw potential in India is incredible.